Jonathan was the kind of boy who liked to cut worms into with his teeth.
What's become of him?
I don't know. He wanted to become a surgeon like grandfather, but he didn't want to go to medical school first. And his practice got him into trouble.
Aren't you two going to be late for dinner?
We're skipping dinner, and we shouldn't have to start for about half an hour.
Mm-hmm.
tonight, I can't make it.
No, Al, you're wrong. I'll tell you all about it tomorrow.
Well, Jordan's got to come and play for me tonight. This is my apartment, and I'm running it. Now you get a hold of George.
And now let's see. Where were we?
Thank you.
got to get somebody. Who else is there around the office?
Is there always this much noise?
Well, there must be somebody around the place. Oh, look, Al, what about the office boy? You know, the bright one, the one we don't like. All right, well, you look around the office and I'll hold on.
Anyway,
you'll do this for me, won't you?
Martha, it's good to be home again.
against military protocol. Yeah, you have to tell him. It's his department.
Announce that the president will have a few words to say.
remember you as the most detestable,
no,
vicious,
never,
venomous form of animal life I ever knew.
Now don't you two boys start quarreling again the minute you see each other.
There won't be any fight, Aunt Abby. Jonathan, you're not wanted here. Get out.
Actually, we've been invited to stay.
Not in this house.
Well, just for tonight.
I don't want him anywhere near me.
But we did invite him to stay tonight, and if it wouldn't be very nice to go back on our word.
That's right. But first thing in the morning, out. Where are they sleeping?
We put them in Jonathan's old room.
That's my old room. I'm sleeping there. I'm here to stay.
Oh, whatever, I'm so glad.
Please sleep down here with my truck.
You bet you like to sleep down here.
You sleep on this sofa, I sleep on the window. Yeah. All right, okay.
Oh, the window seat. Oh, let's not argue about it any longer. That window seat's good enough for me for tonight. I'll sleep on the window. Don't bother, Doctor.
But, Doctor, I've seen the last chat of our good friend, Mr. Spinoza.
Who's this, Mr. Spinoza?
Oh, just a friend of ours from we've been looking for.
Well, don't let anyone else in here.
He's on my Johnny. Without me back, I tell you forward about it, okay? All right, come on, let's go.
You're just wasting your time. I told you I'm sleeping down here.
Mortimer.
What's the matter, dear?
I've almost been killed.
You've almost been... Abby! Martha! came back to Brooklyn, Jonathan, because it gives me the chance to throw you out. And the first one out is your boyfriend, Mr. Spinalt.
Two in Johannesburg, the one in Sydney, the two in San Francisco, the one in Phoenix, Arizona.
Hey, hey, hey.
when he signs his committed papers, I can tackle Jonathan.
What did I have to do with this?
You have to go and tell Jonathan about those 12 graves. If I can make Teddy responsible for those, I can protect you. Don't you see?
No, I don't see. We pay taxes for the police to protect us.
I'll be back down. Thank you. Matt, sees now you're safe.
When do you think you'll be ready to start?
Mr. Witherspoon, why don't you go upstairs and tell Teddy just what you should take along?
Upstairs? I'll show you.
Oh, no, Mortimer. We want to talk to you. Yes, Mr. Witherspoon, just upstairs and to the left.
Don't worry, Aunt. You're going to love it. Ha, 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 ha.